Good afternoon, students. So today we are here to discuss the next part of our syllabus. So it's a long gap. So after a long gap, we are here to discuss. So before starting to the next part, I want to discuss the whatever I have covered in the last class. Okay. So I think in last class we had solved the problems on design of fillet weld. I think these are the problems we have solved. So the problems like the two plates connected over each other. So we have designed the welded connection for that, and even we have provided the weld equally on both the side like this. Okay. So after that, the next part I think I have started in the class. So that is fillet weld. That is design of fillet weld for truss members. Okay. So as I discussed in class, so truss members are nothing but like angle sections. So here, so we can provide the length of weld as you can longitudinal weld, even we can provide the longitudinal as well as transverse weld. That is longitudinal weld is L1 and L2, and if you want to provide the transverse weld L1, L2 and L3, L3 will be the transverse weld, which is shown in figure 1 and figure 2. So if you see in the figure 1, the only transverse weld is provided, so that is L1 and L2, and P1 and P2, those are the forces which are offered by length L1 and L2, means whatever the force P transferred from the section, okay, that should be offered by the length of weld L1 and L2. And in case of figure 2, whatever the force is there, that should be equally shared, or it is shared based on the properties of the angle L1, L2 and L3, okay. And H1, H2, that is the location of the centroid of the angle section, okay, which are going to get from the steel table. So here, so L1 and L2 are the longitudinal weld, and P1 and P2 are the load carried by L1 and L2. So the important here, we have to get the moment about the forces in L1 and L2, so that we can easily get. So how can you get that? By taking moment about L1, so you can find out P2 into H or minus P into H1. So we can easily get P2 is equal to P into H1 upon H. So similarly, we can get P1 is equal to P into H2 upon H. So hence, after getting P1 and P2, the force carried by L1 and L2, we can easily design the length of fillet weld L1 and L2. Okay. So after that, so the next, according to figure number 2, here the L1 and L2 are the longitudinal fillet weld, and the LH, that is the transverse weld. Okay. So whatever the force is there, so here total forces are there P1, P2 and P3. So P1 is force carried by L1, P2 is force carried by L2, and P3 is force carried by the transverse fillet weld. Okay. So if I know the because from the steel table I can easily find out the height of the section, so I can easily find out the P3 force carried by the transverse weld. Okay, so that is we can find out H into TE into FU upon 2-3 into gamma MW. So what is H? H is nothing but the height of the section, which will be getting from the steel table. So what will be total length of weld? The total length of the weld will be L1 plus L2 plus H. Okay, so now taking moment about L1, so P2 into H plus P3 into H by 2 minus P into H2, and also taking moment about L2, that is P1 into H plus P3 into H by 2 minus P into H1. Okay, so here we have three equations, that is equation number 1, 2 and 3. So P3 is already known from the equation number 1. So after substituting the value of P3 in equation number 2 and 3, and if you solve, you will get the values of P1 and P2 very easily. Okay. So once you get the value of P1 and P2, we can design the weld according to the force carried by L1 and L2. Okay. So let's move on to, we'll solve one problem over that. Okay. So the statement of the problem like this, we have to design a tie member, we have to design weld. The problem is like this. A tie member consisting of an ISA 80 by 50 by 8, so it's angle section 80 by 50 by 8, is welded to 12 mm thick gusset plate at site. Design the weld to transfer load is equal to design strength of member. So we have to design a weld to transfer the design strength of the member. Now, if you see in the figure, if you see, this is the adjustments are provided, like we have LW1, LW2 and P1 and P2, and these LW1 and LW2 we have to design to carry a force is nothing but what is the design strength of the member. Okay. Now here the angle section is unequal because it is 80 by 50 because both the legs are not equal. So we can assume that what, because which leg is connected to gusset plate we don't know. So assuming long leg is connected to gusset plate, so we have to assume that, and based on that we have to find out the properties of the angle section from the steel table. Okay, property is nothing but you have to find out area, and we have to find out what is the location of centroidal axis, because in design it is assumed that, or it is a assumption in the design of steel structure, whatever the force is carried by the member, it should act through the centroid. I'll repeat once again, it should act through centroid. So we should know what are the centroidal distance. Okay, we can easily get those from steel table. Okay, now if you see here, this is a small capture from the steel table again. So it is a equal angle. Equal angle, how we can say both the legs are same. Okay, so we can see it is a equal angle. So here we can see there are two distances from CG, it is CXX. So there is a small correction here. The correction is what, from centroid towards the junction, from centroid towards the junction it is CXX, and from centroid towards the toe or the end of the angle it is EXX. Please make the correction, from the center to towards the junction. Junction means where the two legs meets, okay, where the two legs joins. Okay, so that is CXX, and from the center to the end or towards the toe of the angle, so it is EXS. So same way we have about vertical axis, that is CYY and EYY, but there is a correction in the steel table, those who are using Birla, okay, there is a correction, it is EXX or EYY. Okay, so it similarly we have the diagram for an equal angle. We can see from the sketch both the legs are not equal, so it is a unequal angle. Okay, now this is these are the properties or the table, you will get it from steel table, so where we can get the properties. Okay, so here we have the angle like 80 by 50 by 8, so for that there are the properties like area, we have CXX, CYY, EXX, EYY, everything. Okay, so from this we have to get the properties, and we have to use these data for the solution of problem. Okay, now if you see here, once again I'll go back to just cover. So we will assume that the long leg is connected to gusset plate, and we'll go ahead for the solution of the problem. Okay, from the above table we can get the value of CXX and EXX, so that is nothing but H1 and H2 for leg length 80 mm. So we have got the values like CXX and EXX, that is H1 and H2, that is 27.3 and 52.7. These are the values are used for the calculation of forces P1 and P2. So we'll come back to the next part.